He's an absolute stud. He is, I mean, they call him the human highlight and the most exciting guy in the game, and it is true, but not just the game, in all of combat sports. There is no fighter in the world of sports that is more exciting than Justin Gaethje. Boxing, kickboxing, mixed martial arts, you'll find nobody more exciting and better.
The dude's a savage. You know, he's an absolute savage. The way he fights, the way he brings it. He's a wrestler. He's an American wrestler, just like me. So, obviously, I'm a fan of his style.
Justin Gaethje's a monster. Justin Gaethje is a monster. He's a monster. He's a terrifying individual. He is, I mean, in a sport that's violent, it's an inherently violent sport, he stands out as the most violent. You watch his knockout of Edson Barboza, you watch how that motherfucker attacks people. There's a reckless abandon to his calculated wildness that is, it's terrifying.
You're spot on. And there are factors to it. You know, there are reasons why Justin's so dangerous. One, his ability to wrestle defensively. He's a high-level wrestler. I know he doesn't use his wrestling offensively as much as people might want to see, but he's a high-level wrestler, NCAA All-American. His boxing and stand-up is as good as it comes. He's got fantastic cardio, and he's got an iron chin.
They see this, like, cyborg robot step into the cage. Like, that's what they think he, they don't even look at him as a man. They don't look at him as like he has a heart and a spirit and his brain. They just look at a guy who goes out there and he's gonna just freaking try to break somebody just through sheer, not beautiful technique, but just pressure and punch count and leg kicks and that kind of stuff.
Hands up high, moving in on you, and just leg kicks from close distance and brawling. And that guy can't do that very long.
He seems to thrive in that chaos, right? When it gets uglier and dirtier and more grimy, Justin's smiling, right? He's smiling, he's cut up, he's gotten dropped multiple times. Dude's smiling.
One of the most interesting and intriguing contenders to enter into the UFC has a spectacular debut against Michael Johnson in a fucking war.
Yeah.
I mean, just a fucking war. And then loses to Eddie Alvarez in spectacular fashion, and then loses to Dustin Poirier in spectacular fashion.
He lost to two guys, right? Me and Dustin. Two guys who both held gold, both champions. Other than that, he absolutely obliterated every single opponent they put in front of him. Not beat. He beat the shit out of like some of the top guys in the world. So it's difficult for me to think that he's not gonna hold that gold in his hand at some point. He's got Trevor behind him. He trains with Usman, who's also a champion, and I feel like they have all their ducks in line to put him on a championship run.
I hope so. I want to see it, because I think if Gaethje like starts incorporating his wrestling, he can like go the whole way. He's a great fighter. Yeah, I guess we just got to see what he wants to do.
And I just want to tell everybody watching this, this is a life lesson. This isn't about fighting. You got to understand and appreciate the position you put yourself in and be grateful for everything you have, because all these months of Gaethje walking around and throwing that belt down could have been months of him embracing the position, embracing the role that he put himself in, not trying to be a meathead and throwing the belt on the ground and trying to say cool shit.
And new interim champion Justin Gaethje. Do you not want that on you? Why'd you just throw that off?
Wait for the real one.
If you wear glasses or contacts, you must see this. An award-winning doctor reveals an astonishing, natural way to reclaim the 2020 vision you were born with in record time. Did you know? Vision problems have absolutely nothing to do with your eyes. A shocking link between the eyes and the brain was discovered by research.
I want the real one. Dude, we know you have a piece of the real one right there on your shoulder that you're throwing around and disrespecting. I honor my work. That's why I carry that belt with pride. I just wanted to put that out there. All those months of him being an interim champion could have been great months if he wouldn't have been throwing that belt on the ground.
And I think it goes back to when I look at him, you know, it's not a knock on him or whatever. I just don't think he has the confidence in his abilities. There's a fine line between having confidence in your abilities, confidence in your striking techniques, your ability to win any other way than a brawl. Because I've had these thoughts too, and I've sat and I've thought, and the thought of me just outclassing somebody and piecing them up and the whole world watching and hearing the announcer saying, oh my God, Michael Chandler's striking is on another level. Look at this. And then, and how he strings together his punches with his kicks and blah, blah, blah. That felt foreign and it felt uncomfortable to me because I didn't 100% truly believe in that stuff until recently. And you start, and I think he only has the capacity to believe in himself as a brawler. Therefore, that's the only way he knows how to win. Therefore, in his sparring rounds, he's not, I bet you and I could go watch him, and he's the same guy, Justin Gaethje, in those sparring rounds as he is in the cage.
I'd like to think if we uploaded our sparrings that we me and him have, we'd make tons of money.
I think Usman was the guy who really put the pace on. Kamaru was just showed up, and man, he can put on a pace, and Justin just kept up with him, no problem. It would be Kamaru, and then it would be myself. And I was thinking to myself, what the heck? Justin is a freaking, he's a machine, man. And Mike, I made sure to get into the positions that are most uncomfortable for Justin. I made sure to go out there and do everything awkward and do everything with a surprise. So, and Justin just kind of walk through everything, including training with Kamaru. I was really impressed, man. I thought to myself, dude, this guy is special.
He's just a chaotic individual as far as bringing the fight to me, which is one thing that I like. I never like to step into the octagon and have anything feel foreign to me. And Justin does a good job of putting you in the fire, so you feel the fire during camp. So, you know, I appreciate that about him, and much, much respect to him.
With his wrestling ability and his striking ability, I believe that he's dangerous. But I there's even something that stands out to me more. It's the confidence. I mean, this dude believes that he's going to win. There's no doubt in his mind.
Oh, absolutely. And then, as I was just about to say, he also has the wrestling. You don't see Gaethje use his wrestling, but he has it. I think he was a state champion on multiple occasions, but he just likes to throw the hands. And we saw against Tony Ferguson, the hands were the best they've ever been.
I think the Justin Gaethje that stepped into the cage against Tony Ferguson was arguably the best lightweight on the planet that night. Calm, composed, confident, throwing heavy leather. We know he has good wrestling because he was an All-American. I personally watched him wrestle in college. I know he's a good wrestler. I know he's a scrappy wrestler.
Man, I love Justin. He's such a great guy. So what happened was when I was I fought in Denver. I fought Thiago Moises in Denver, and Justin reached out to me and said, hey, you need a place to train. You can come to my place. And, you know, the way he reached out and helped me out, I was so grateful. And after the fight, I told Coach Trevor, look, if Justin ever needs me, I'm here.
Justin Gaethje, whenever he wants to go, that's the fight I want. That's the fight that lights a fire under me. You know, you watch him fight, you go out and see him. The way he fights, the way he knocks people out, the way he finishes me.
What?
He finishes me, finishes different opponents. And that's, you can feel the threat. And so it makes it very easy to train for. When you're fighting such a dangerous opponent like that, it makes it very easy to get in the gym. It makes it very easy to train hard. You know, when you don't prepare for a fighter like that, who's as exciting as that, who's as threatening and dangerous as that, then it's you got to drag yourself to the gym. You got to push yourself through the hard sessions. But a fighter like Justin Gaethje, that's an exciting fight to me. That's an exciting fight for the fans.
You know, when I fight was Justin Gaethje last fight. It was like when I go to the cage, you know, this guy, he hit like truck, you know, like nobody hit harder me, harder than Justin Gaethje. His kick, his punch, his left hook, right hook.
You want to see me fight, and if you don't see me fight live, you will regret it when I'm done. And it's not going to be very long. I got about five left.